In this video, we'll solve the third type of percent problem using a percent equation. And to set up our equation, we need to remember that is represents equals, of represents multiplication, and for what number or what percent, we'll use a variable, which we'll be solving for. And the last thing to remember is if we are given the percentage, we need to express it as a decimal. So we want to know 68 is what percent of 1,720. So to create the equation, we'll have 86 is, represents equals. Then we have what or what percent, which will be our variable. But to remind ourselves, the answer will be a percentage. I'm going to use the variable p of means multiplication. And then we have 1,720. Let's rewrite our equation as 86 equals, and p times 1,720 is just 1,720p. So to solve this equation for p, we'll have to divide both sides by 1,720. So here we'll have p, and then we'll determine this quotient. So we have 86 divided by 1,720. And so p is equal to 0.05. But we're actually trying to determine a percentage, and this is the decimal form of the percentage. So to convert this to a percentage, we'll multiply by 100 and add a percent symbol, which is the same as moving the decimal place to the right two places. So this is 5%. So let's go back and take a look at our question. We've determined that 86 is 5% of 1,720. And since 86 is a very small part of this large number, 5% does seem like a reasonable answer. Now that you've seen how to solve the three basic types of percent problems using the percent equation, you may find it helpful to watch the videos that show how to solve the same three types of problems using the percent proportion instead.